going to talk today about incubators. We've got a commercially available incubator here, and we got a do-it-yourself incubator here. We're going to focus mostly on the do-it-yourself one. But when we harvest queen cells from our cell builder colonies, we take the frame out. I've got one right here. So we take that out of our cell builder, and we keep it vertical. We try not to bump the frame at all, and we gently brush the bees off the off these cells. And then we bring that the frame in to our workshop, where it's a nice warm temperature, we're out of the wind, and we have all the tools and so on at our disposal. So we can then take each of these individual queen cells off the bar here, and then transfer them into the incubator. But let's have a look at the incubators first. The commercially available one has a tray inside that we can put the cells in individually. Underneath that, there's a heating element built into the toolbox design here. And so that's heating up from the bottom. And it's set to heat at 32 to 34 degrees to keep Celsius, to keep the cells at the brood nest temperature. It's 12 volts, so we can plug it into our vehicle battery, or into our vehicle, or into a battery, or into a battery charger. So that's the commercial unit. This is worth about $1,000, so not everybody's going to want to be going out and buying one of those. And I really think we need to be thinking about using queen cells more in beekeeping than we do right now. So I'd really love it if people were able to learn more about how to handle those cells. It's really not that hard to do. And there are some key advantages to using queen cells. Number one, they're available earlier in the spring. So in our area here, that's an advantage because people want to make up splits fairly early. Number two, when you use a queen cell, the colony you introduce that to goes through a broodless period, which means the vromite levels crash. So it's a really effective way of controlling your vromites in the spring so that the buildup through the rest of the summer is much slower. So that's another advantage. They're much cheaper than a mated queen, and they're generally locally available from local bee breeder or queen rearer. For the queen rearer, some advantages there are that they don't need to have all their mating nucleus colonies set up, and they can crank out lots of queen cells. So the only disadvantage is that you only get half of the genetics from that queen rearer or bee breeder, but that's not such a significant disadvantage. Let's look at the do-it-yourself incubator now. So it's a, let's see here, it's a 16 quart or 22 liter incubator. That's an ideal size. And then inside that we have a hot water bottle. We've done some experiments with this to know that we're getting the right temperature and know how well it works. We run our tap until the tap is as water is as hot as it's going to be. And then we fill that right up with the hot water. And then we spoof our incubator, or move that into our incubator here. Just lay that down in the bottom of the incubator. And you can see it's a nice fit in the bottom there. And then we fill this up so that we have shavings going 4 inches above the top of that hot water bottle. That insulates the hot water bottle so the cells that we're going to put in don't get too hot from the hot water. In about 10-15 minutes, the temperature in here comes up to the brood nest temperature. So we'll put the shavings in now, and we'll fill that up to our pre-marked 4 inches here. We just pour those in, fill it up to 4 inches there, kind of level it out. A little bit more. We set that up, and now what we're going to do is we're going to take the cells off the graft bar. So we've got the frame there that has the graft bars in it. We'll gently take that off, and we'll lean it in here. And we really are careful that we don't tip that over. And then we use our hive tool and pry very gently each individual cell off. We then make a little impression in the shavings with a finger, put the cell in, and then just snug the shavings up around that cell and repeat the process here. In an incubator like this, you can put in 40 or 50 cells, or two or three, whatever you want. Once that's done, got all the cells in there that you want, then we close it up, and that will keep these cells at the correct temperature for up to 5 hours. So that means the beekeeper that's buying the cells from a queen rearer has the time to get those cells home and get them introduced to their queenless colony. It's important that colony has no queen when we're introducing a queen cell. We then leave the cells to hatch out over the next day or two. The queens fly out and mate, and within a couple weeks we should have a mated queen. We just go into the colony and check to see if we have eggs. If so, we have a mated queen. So it's very simple, nothing to it. It's just a matter of handling them carefully, keeping them at the right temperature, and getting them installed in a timely manner. Thanks for watching. See you next time.